Hi guys, it's Rebecca, and oh, I am so excited to be filming this week's video. I have been waiting to do another one of these for so long. I didn't realize how long it had been since I'd done one, which I think is cool because I'm like older and have more insight on things, or at least I tell myself I do. Today, I am doing another advice video. I asked you guys to send me your biggest, greatest issues on Tumblr because clearly, as an 18-year-old girl, I know the answer to everything. These videos always help me out with my life, too, because turns out we have a lot of the same issues, being that I am just an 18-year-old girl trying to do her thing on her own. I may not know the answer to everything, but I'm gonna try to help out the best I can. Think of it as like a big sister kind of a thing. Hi Rebecca, I really want to move to LA for the summer with my friends, but I don't know if it'll be worth the money considering I'm from the UK. Would you recommend it? Okay, so I thought this was perfect. I know a lot of people on the internet have moved to LA in recent years, including myself. It's become this like thing that like, I'm 18, I'm moving out, I'm going to LA. There are a few great things about LA and a few not so great things about LA. And this all really does depend on the person, but just my opinion, if you know what direction you wanna go to, let's say like music is your thing, you wanna be an artist, or maybe you wanna be a songwriter and you've come out here to kind of like explore that. If you have like a clear path and goal of what you wanna be, I think it's a lot easier to make those connections and get there. On the flip side, if you're coming out here to discover yourself or kind of figure out what you wanna do, you're not really sure yet, maybe you're juggling in between a few ideas or just have no idea at all, whether this is after college, after high school, whatever, I do think this is a great place to explore yourself, being that it's a very, what's the right word, diverse city, and you're not gonna find a lot of people that judge you for what you wanna do. Like, there's people out here that do everything and make it work. That being said, it is very easy to get lost out here. It's really easy to get caught up in like the drama and like make it feel almost like you're in a high school situation. As long as you keep yourself focused and keep yourself in check and always do what's best for you, I think it could be a really great place. If I were in your shoes, I would try it out over here. Maybe like rent an Airbnb if you can afford to do that. Stay with a friend if you can and try to like feel it out, because it is a really big transition. Even just me coming from like a city that's an hour away from LA, it was still a really big change. How do I get over a girl I once loved but never had a relationship with? I don't feel anything for her now, but I still find myself checking up on her Twitter every so often to make sure she's all right. Okay, so to be honest, I feel like a lot more people are in your same boat. Sometimes you develop a certain kind of relationship with someone where it's never per se official, but there was definitely something there. Sometimes it's reciprocated, sometimes it's not. To me, time heals all wounds, and time is the best way to get yourself to move on. I definitely always like find myself thinking about someone for a while after it's ended, taking all of that energy that I had for that person and putting it into something for myself that really helps. When I'm trying to move on, I always tend to like make myself really busy with whatever I can do, whether it's like taking up a new hobby or maybe deciding to completely redo my room or doing something different with my career. Like, just focusing on myself and focusing on making myself a better person. Especially if things ended in a negative way and this person ended up being a negative impact on your life, you're really just harming yourself if you're still putting all of that effort into that person. I just turn that into something for me. It's okay to be a little selfish every once in a while. Hey, IDK, if you can help me with this one, but I just feel like I don't belong in my friend group and I don't belong anywhere. I just want to move far away and get a new group of friends. Okay, so I have a lot of experience with this one. I've been to multiple schools and gone through different friend groups and felt so out of place in all of them at one point, whether or not it was their fault or my fault. I would say the first step is gaining the courage to be vocal with them about it. Vocal with them about it and letting them know how you feel. And this is the hardest thing to do. Now, you don't need to like sit all them down and be like, you're all making me feel like shit. But a lot of the time, especially if it's girls, they don't realize how they're making you feel. It's so easy to have so many misunderstandings like that, and even just by bringing it up, it can help a little bit. Now, obviously, there are two very different reactions they could have to this. If you do decide to stick with them and they promise to change, it is also upon yourself to make sure that change happens. A lot of the times, those girls or guys are gonna forget about it within a week or two. And if you start feeling yourself being in that same place again, you have to keep bringing it up until change matters. But if you still do feel really left out after trying to make a change, you really just gotta get yourself some new friends. It is the hardest thing in the world, but having people around you that really care about you and care about the way you feel is the biggest game changer ever, especially when you're growing up. You never know where you're gonna find a new group of friends. It took me like getting out of my comfort zone and talking to that one person I never thought I would get along with, or talking to that one person I normally wouldn't, talk to, and it's honestly really refreshing and like a great way to get a fresh start, but it is really hard. Were you shy when you used to be in school? Because I'm really shy and I want to know how I can overcome my shyness. Before anything with the Friday video happened, or before I started making videos or anything like that, I was never really a shy person. It was after I started making videos and things got a little weird when I went back to high school that I definitely was a different person in that sense. I just found myself trying to be really reserved, and I had a hard time like making friends, just because when I walked into that school, everyone had their own preconceived idea of who I was. Some people thought I was a crazy party girl, other people thought I was like an unsocial prude. I don't know. I just tried to lay low and ignore all of the laughs and weird stares. For me, it took a lot of building my own self-confidence up so that I knew that I could approach people and knew I was normal and there was nothing wrong with me or nothing weird about me. I know sometimes when people are naturally shy, this is how I was, at least when I was in high school. Other people take it as them being standoffish or like not nice. I also am blessed with having resting bitch face, so when I would be sitting there or like maybe like staring at someone without even realizing it, people thought I was just mad at them when I didn't even know them. It definitely took me forcing myself out of my comfort zone, and when it came to like giving presentations or like making group projects, when I would actually put myself out there, I was always so surprised by how nice people were to me. Not all, obviously it's not gonna be like that all the time, but with enough trying and making those efforts, you'll find it easier and easier to come out of your shell. At least I did. I like this guy, but he doesn't even know I exist. How do I get his attention? Help. I'm sure you've heard this before, but it is honestly the only tip I can ever give, because it's the only one that's ever worked for me when it's come to any sort of guy. Just be yourself, as honest and like as unapologetically as you can. Being you and being confident in yourself and who you are is the sexiest, coolest thing to any guy, or at least any really cool guy. You never know like a difference that a simple, confident hello could really make. I have stretch marks and I'm very insecure about it. Any tips on how to overcome my insecurity? A lot more people have stretch marks than you would think. Even the skinniest of girls can still get stretch marks or still have stretch marks. If it makes you feel any better, I have stretch marks and I hate them so much, but I would hate to look back and know that I stopped myself from doing certain things or avoided certain situations just to cover them up. I just spent an entire week on the beach in a bathing suit with my stretch marks just sitting there. When I realized that a lot more people had them than I thought, and realized that everyone is so focused on how they look, not really on how other people look, there really is no need to think of yourself as ugly or fat or disgusting just because you've stretch marks. Lots and lots of people have them. Okay, so I think I have talked myself out for the day. I am gonna try to get this video up by noon, being that it's literally 9:51 a.m. I am so sorry if it's up a little bit late. Just got back from Mexico last night, so trying to get this up. I think we're good. Thank you guys so much for watching and for sending in your questions, and I hope you're having a really awesome 2016. If you would like me to bring more videos like this back in the future, let me know in the comments below or by giving this video a big thumbs up, and be sure to subscribe if you're new to my channel and you know, want to see more. All of my social media links are down in the description, and I will see you very soon. Love ya.